Polyplay is a microcap crypto that has started to get a little bit of traction in the last while, and the graphs have been moving in a general upward direction, and a lot of investors starting to get quite excited and quite giddy about Polyplay. So I wanted to jump in and just quickly have a look at some of the tokenomics, have a look at some of the fundamentals, and figure out what this project is all about and if it is worth investing into. Before we jump into this video, I just want to ask you a really big favor. I need you to click on that like button and turn it blue because it helps us with the YouTube algorithm. So if you can go ahead and click on the like button now. So as I mentioned, there's been quite a bit of activity here in the last couple of days. Last 7 days, in fact, this has really been hitting a little bit of a breakout. And a lot of people starting to talk about Polyplay. So I wanted to jump in and have a look what it's all about. So of course, the coin is Polyplay and they trade under the symbol Play. Now, if you do want additional information beyond what I'm providing here and you want to access the white papers and some more of the technical information that's available, you can go to polyplay.net. Now, if we have a look at the project start date, we can see it is still very new, July 24, 2021. So it's just the other day it was launched. They have a market cap of 8.8 million, and of course, the same for their fully diluted value. The price right now, as of making this video, is 8.17. The lowest price it's been is 4.09, and the highest price it's been is $28. Now the return on investment on the low would be 717% had you invested back then. I could not find any subreddits for them. However, they have 8,500 people following them on Twitter. They have no market dominance database. Of course, this is a microcap, so they just obviously don't feature much in terms of the grand scheme. Market rank, they're sitting at 2,731. Just to give you guys some indication, there are about 5,300 projects on cryptocurrency at the moment. And of course, 2,700 means they're just over the halfway mark. So they're definitely not the worst, but there is a lot of cryptocurrency projects out there to compete with. So then coming down and looking at some of the tokenomics, it is of course a token. They are operating on the BSC protocol and they are using proof of work. Unfortunately, I could not pick up any details about the algorithm that's employed. However, they are of course on that Binance blockchain. Also, the block time is unknown as well as the circulating supply. However, they have a max in total supply of 1 million tokens, which is of course hard capped. Then coming down to the holder data, and this is just something that drives me absolutely wild. I couldn't find any data on the holders. And of course, I just haven't got the time or patience to go and token sniff every single transaction that was done to figure it out. But frankly speaking, I wish these cryptocurrency projects, especially the newer ones, would learn something that investors and speculators are looking for. And this is that we want to see the concentration of the holder data. So if you are involved with the project and there is perhaps a way for us to access this data in a very simple way and have it displayed to us without having to dig like we're mining for this data, and if you are interested in some transparency and you're involved with the project, please listen to what we're saying, make the holder data available. Now, coming down to these sentiment scores, the project does not score very well, and I need to say that this is a new project, so just keep that in mind. It obviously needs a little bit of time to mature. So Polyplay currently scoring about 20%, so very, very poor. They've got 2.7 for development, 0.9 for sentiment, 2.5 for community, 0 for awareness, which I think is pretty much self-explanatory, credibility 0.5, and they're actually not doing too bad on volume at 3.6. Now, like I said, this is a new project, so, you know, just bear in mind that these sentiment scores will change as the project becomes a little bit better known, and hopefully it is still around then. Now, coming down to the price forecasting, before we jump into the price forecast, guys, I just need to make it clear, this is not my own price predictions. This is based on a computer algorithm. It takes into account lots of different data points, and it's based on what is currently happening. Now, of course, sentiment can change it very quickly, so just keep that in mind. And I think if for nothing else, it is useful to see what the computer algorithm predicts. So currently sitting at 8.31, the end of 2021, it's predicting to go to 12. And then by the end of 2028, it's predicting 37.33. So generally speaking, the algorithm is predicting a general upward trend for the crypto. So I think that's a pretty good thing. Now, the next thing we try and do is we try and have a look at the unique utility or the unique properties that the project has. Because with 5,300 plus crypto projects out there, you know, they're all pretty much doing the same thing. Most of them pretty much just copying each other. So we really want to find out what is the unique thing about this project. So Polyplay aims to host esports tournaments. Now, of course, they're not the only coin that's looking to do it. So I think that just is one thing that's important to note. They're looking to do these tournaments for all amateur players, which is unique. And obviously, they're looking to create a sizable pool for prizes, which would be funded by the transactions made on the project blockchain. So I actually think this is a project that might have merits over the long term. Obviously, still very shaky to put any money into this, but then so are most cryptocurrencies. So I think with that in mind, and the fact that there is a hard cap on the number of tokens, this is a project that's definitely worth keeping your eye on. However, I will not be putting any of my money into the project at this point. So I'd be very interested to know what your thoughts are. I'd be interested to know what your comments are around the project. And of course, there is a lot of irrationality when it comes to cryptocurrency reviews. And we obviously try and provide the most balanced and logical perspective and looking at key metrics. We don't go all the way down into the technical papers and all the applications beyond what we're providing here. And we really just want to give people a quick overview and let them know what is going on with the project. So before any of the holders come and just go absolutely buck wild in the comment section below, please bring some rationality to the debate. And if you've got something to add, please do it in a respectful manner in the comments down below. And of course, if you did enjoy this video, please click the like button to help us get this content out, because YouTube, for some reason, likes to rank videos when you guys click on the like video. So we really, on the like button on the video. So we really would appreciate that. And of course, if this is your first time visiting our channel, please consider subscribing. Before you go, I'd like to invite you to subscribe to our channel and join the Global Money Tribe. And because I know you need a little bit of extra motivation every month, I'm going to be giving away a signed copy of my book, The Money Secret, as well as some really cool channel merch. So if that's not a big enough motivation to subscribe, come and subscribe for the content, because every single day we're adding absolutely great content teaching you to invest, save, and manage your money situation.